Hi everybody, my name is Charu Behel and I'm a consultant at EPMA. Today I'm going to talk about various methods to update your schedule using Microsoft Project 2013. Now basically there are three methods to update your project progress, and the method you choose to update depends on the nature of work being performed in your organization. Now the very first method I'm going to explain is called the percent complete method. It is an estimated ratio of actual work performed versus total amount of work to be completed. Now to do that, the very first step that I would do is, I would right click and insert a column called percent complete column. Once I do that, I would go under the view ribbon and under the tables drop down, I would select the tracking table. Now here you would see the two columns called the actual start and the actual finish. A lot of time what happens is that due to the schedule slippage, your actual start date is different from what you had planned earlier. And you want to make sure that the task A is reported on time. So, for example, in this task, instead of starting on the 10/6 schedule start date, it starts on 10/13. And you see what happens. Microsoft Project automatically pushes out the schedule by a week. And now, once I know my actual start date, I can actually go back to my entry table and select the task that I want to update. Under the task ribbon and under the schedule section, I can see all these bars varying from 0% to 100%. Now, once I mark my project task as 100% complete, there is this write or check mark that appears in the indicator section showing that the task is 100% complete. And one very interesting thing that you would want to see is that once the task is complete, the actual finish date is automatically populated as the scheduled finish date. The second method is called the actual work and remaining work method. It is a measure of total actual work hours performed to date and the estimated number of work that has remaining. Now again, to update task B, I would want to make sure that my actual start date is correct, assuming that it started as planned. I would go under the view ribbon and under my tables, I will select the work table. Now, in this table, you would see these two columns called as the actual work and the remaining work column. Now, to update task B, you see that the scheduled work or the planned work was for 96 hours. And the actual work that has been done till now is 0%, that means 0 hours, and remaining is 96 hours of work. Now, once I mark this task as 50% complete, you see what happens, remaining is 48 and actual is 48 as well. And once I mark it as 100, the actual is 96% and the remaining is 0%. This method is a little better than the percent complete method because it actually gives manager the flexibility to put in the actual number of hours. Now, for example, the number of hours that were actually put into this task were more than, say, 96 hours. So what happens if I enter 104 hours? you see that again the scheduling engine makes way for 104 hours and the schedule is pushed out by a day. Now the third method is called the actual work per period, and it is a measure of actual work performed during each time period, which may vary from a week to a day to a month depending on your organization and the estimated number of work hours remaining. Now to do that, I would again go under the view section, and under the table drop down menu I would select the work, and now under the view I would select my task usage view, and okay, so now you see on the right hand side how my task is divided on basis of day. So now the manager or the scheduler has the ability to break it down to the number of days, and there's an increased granularity to the whole process. Now for task C, I would right click and say actual work. Okay, now you can actually see where my task starts, right here. And now on Monday, suppose my resource works as planned, and you see how everything changes. What if on the next day, instead of 8 hours, my resource only works for 6 hours? You see how the actual is automatically updated to 6 hours, and the planned is updated to 6 hours, and the remaining 2 hours get scheduled once this task is over. Now, this is again a very flexible method that a manager can use to update his or her schedule. Keep watching out for more videos and quick tips. You can also visit our website. I hope you enjoyed the video. Goodbye for now.